What is going on, guys? It is Marksman here, and I have your daily dose of Search and Destroy. Today, I got a gameplay for you on Carrier using the B23R extended clip and the, what is this, DSR dual band and the thingy on top of it that makes it waverless. Ballistic CPU. And yeah, you guys wanted sniper gameplay. Some people asked for it. I'm tired of doing M8s. M8 gameplay is just like, that's what you go to now. Like an M8, FAL, or an AN94 are the top three weapons in the game because they fucked up the SMGs so much that they just cannot compete very well. I mean, you can do it. I have a really good game I got a few days ago with an SMG, with the MSMC. And you can use, you know, the Vector, and you can use the PDW still, and you can use, what is it, the MP7. But in general, rifles just happen to be better, especially for gameplays, because usually gameplays are ruined by camping kids, and camping kids don't tend to get kills on rifles because rifle players play slower. That's, I don't know, that's just how I feel. But not about the topic. Doesn't make a difference. That's not the topic. Topic is about you guys. In general, I think that why people want shout-outs on YouTube and things like that is because they want, you know, some subscribers or some active people on their videos checking them out, sharing them, and liking them, and commenting. And although commenting is it's pretty important, I think that, you know, the most important thing by far is for people to have their social media sites linked with their YouTube and to like videos. Because I think liking videos, this is why I don't ask for likes, but I know a lot of commentators that do. I say, you know, if you like it, go ahead, comment, rate, and subscribe. Rate means like it or dislike it, whatever. But, you know, it's up to you if you guys want to. It's just like a saying I have at the end. It's not really like a really strong reminder. I'm not like, you guys should like this video because that's all. But a lot of people do that. A lot of people do that. And there's no problem with it because, you know, they want to remind you if you do like the video, like it. But in general, what is really depending on a channel's success is the ability for the people that do watch it to share the videos. And you might say, oh, well, Marks, when we share your videos, we have friends we tell about. It's like all that. But I'm not saying that at all. I mean, of course, there are people that do that. But sharing goes way, 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 way further than just, you know, telling a friend or something like that. That helps. Of course, word of mouth is still sharing a video. But in general, in today's, you know, internet life and internet world, having your social media sites like Facebook and Twitter linked with your YouTube account so that when you like a video or you comment on a video, it shares it on your YouTube, on your Twitter and your Facebook feed, that is what shares videos. That's what makes channels grow. Having a lot of people that do that on a consistent basis is why channels can blow up. Obviously, you need to create good videos that people do like because no one's going to like shitty videos. That's natural, right? I don't like videos that often because, you know, I think that if there's going to be something that I really like, it has to be good. It just has to be good. And it's because, you know, I have people that are watching stuff that I like and their opinion on what and who I am might be changed based off of what I like and what I'm, you know, trying to promote or kind of promoting. And you know, liking really isn't about promotion always. I mean, some larger channels think about it that way, but you should just think about it in a simplified fact that if you like something, you should like it. That's easy. It's easy. And I break the rule. Trust me. A lot of the dubstep My Little Pony music I first listened to, never would have liked it. I was like, fuck that, add it to watch later. No one's going to fucking find out I watch this shit. And that was how it was like. And I was like, all right, okay, I'll do that. And you can do that too. I mean, if you want people to be like, all right, I don't want this fucker to know I'm a gamer. I'm not going to like any of this stuff. I'm not linking anything. I'm going to add it to my watch later list and be a closet gamer. Boom. Problem solved. And it works that way if you want to. But channel's success is entirely based off of the spreadability of it. And things are much more spreadable. And I say spreadable in the case that, you know, how something can disperse around the internet based off of the people that watch the videos. Because, of course, like I said, the videos matter if they're likable and if they're good content. But at the same time, it's so important to have an initial base of, I don't want to say fans, but viewers that will share content on many different social sites along with friends. Because, you know, if you have, you know, maybe you share it with three or four friends, two friends pick it up and they start watching it, they like it, they share it on their social sites, and it's a huge growth. And I don't want to call it like a, I hate to say butterfly effect because it's a load of shit sometimes, but it is almost like that where, you know, you could get one person that is responsible for hundreds of new subscribers it's like a pyramid scheme almost. It's like a pyramid scheme, and that's how YouTube operates for channel growth. And it's weird to think about it like that because pyramid schemes are seen as bad things. But in YouTube, that's how channels are grown. And it's that's how almost any channel, and not even, you know, just YouTube, it's almost how any channel has grown, or any type of site that you're trying to share content on, whether it be Twitter and followers retweeting does it there, whether it be Tumblr for people reblogging things, whether it be, you know, WordPress for people quoting a WordPress, you can quote a WordPress in a comment. So if you go to a WordPress and you're like, oh, this was a really interesting article, I read something similar on whatever, quote it there, it leads more people to that. The spreadability and how a channel is grown is entirely based off of the community and the people that watch it, and whether or not those people not only like the content, but whether they share it. And sharing it is the important thing. And it's why I try to create, many different ways for people to share. They can share it by liking it. They can share it by hitting the share button and using it on one of the 40,000 sites that YouTube has their shares linked to. There's like Orkin is one, I think. I don't even know what Orkin, I never even use that. But there are so many out there. And I'd say, you know, the primary ones are probably Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, WordPress, other YouTube pages, of course, is a big thing. But in general, you know, those are probably some of the most primary ones that people share stuff with. And that's fine because, you know, those sites generally have the most traffic on them anyway. It's not like a lot of people are going to MySpace nowadays. Like, I wonder what YouTube videos this person is liking and looking in their MySpace feed for it. You know, it just doesn't happen as often. But channel's growth is entirely dependent on you guys. And I'm not saying this because it's like, oh, everyone should like this video for that reason. I'm saying this because if you want your channel to grow, you not only need to focus on your videos and focus on your commentary and focus on your content, but you need to focus on telling people that if you like this, you want to make sure that they like it as well. And if you want people to like something, you can't just make content based off of your own desires, if you wanted to call that. I mean, you can start that way. I've started that way plenty of times. I do my own videos that I like, but at the same time, I ask you guys all the time, what would you like to see? You guys want to see another Analyze a Random video? You guys wanted to see sniper gameplay? You guys wanted to see all that stuff? I'm trying to do all of that stuff too, but at the same time, I want to maintain that, you know, this is my channel. This is the stuff that I want to post. Anyways, that's the video. Hope you enjoyed. Comment, rate, and subscribe if you'd like. If not, no worries. I will still love you, and as always, make sure to keep on gaming.